Hey, faithful listeners to the program. How's it going? Vern here, driving back. It's a midday show, midday edition. I'm actually stopping right now, kind of strangely. I'm on a special kind of mission trip. I'm actually getting something right now. Picking something up off the side of the road. It's a large frame. So I just put the car in park, unlock the doors, and I'm gonna take this. There's actually a large frame and a little frame. Right, it's pretty big. Tonight is gonna make for a nice art piece. Thanks, sir. This guy. Yeah, that's kind of dirty actually. I'm gonna leave that there. Alright. Some other crap. Make sure that's in there. Okay. Alright, so. Sorry if that was first step here. I'm a. Three-stop trip, I believe. I'm heading back from a lunch break. It's already looking like it's going to be too long of a lunch break. But what are you going to do? It's 1:54 p.m. So I just picked up a frame that's pretty big. It's probably 4 feet wide and 3 feet height. So that's going to make for a nice piece, I think. It's a weird, like, plexiglass, almost like a homemade-looking frame, but very nicely put together. Cardboard backing I'll just remove. I think I can stitch together some pieces behind it. It's all theoretical. I have a lot of junk, and that's part of my hoarding tendencies, but I do make some art. Sometimes you see people on that show, and they're never working on anything, and they say, well, I want to save it for a craft or an art project, but they don't ever get to do any of that. But I think I do. I could do more. I could always be working harder and doing more. So it's always going to be on the old platform. But anyway, so I'm going a different route. So this is actually the first time we've done the show. A couple of points I want to talk about. First off, okay, so it's 1:55. I'm heading to get gas now, so I'm heading to get gas. That's when I'll end the show, prior to pulling up to the gas station. But before then, I'm thinking about going into the liquor store, which is right across from the gas station, which gives me an excuse to go into the cheaper gas station, which is not really on the way back to work exactly. But it does give me an excuse to get in there. I'm thinking about maybe getting like a Sparks or something because I'm driving to Philadelphia tonight. Now, that seems dangerous. But if you think about it, it's just a time saver / get pumped for the show kind of road party. And that way I don't have to drink too much of the show and I can drive home and be fine. But just going there, obviously this is an illegal act and I'm probably, I'm hesitant to even do it. Talking about it is probably not the best idea either. But I'm gonna see what they have to offer, maybe, and I have to get cigarettes anyway, I think. So I'm gonna head in there. I don't have a pocket on my shirt. I was gonna keep tape rolling. Well, we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. We're about a few minutes away, at least. I gotta put the windows up. Can you hear me? Okay. And then anyway, tonight, well, on the way home after I go see the Clean. In Philadelphia, I'm going to do an entire drive home edition of this show, the Drive Time program. I'm gonna set it up in my car so that I can hook up. I'll have this thing that I have that I can prop up my phone, and so I can do a hands-free drive home as my phone's charging. If it needs to be charged, if not, I'll just. It'll be this long, 45, it's about a 45 minutes to an hour drive, give or take. So that'll be later tonight, that'll be episode B, which I'll break up into few different tiny episodes around 50 minutes each. Don't have any guests lined up, I don't believe, for the night show that we have planned, but maybe, you never know, some last minute additions we could get some people to talk to. So that is that. This is a much nicer drive road I'm on right now. Obviously, I'm going taking kind of a long way home that loops by this liquor store, which is in another town. And there's also the cheapest gas that I know of in the area, so I have to fill my tank up before I go down there. And I don't envision doing the show on the way there to the concert because I need that time to kind of, that's kind of my rock out time. I need to get myself psyched. I need to listen to the band that I'm gonna go see. The two bands that are playing tonight. The two bands playing tonight are The Clean, obviously from New Zealand, from the 80s into today. Some older gentlemen. And very rare. I looked at online today and I noticed that they're only doing about a 6 or 7 day tour, which seems very odd. And I don't know, and I don't think that they're supporting any new material per se. That struck me as a little odd that they're only doing it this few amount of shows. They're on Merge Records, and their label mates are a band called Times New Viking, and Times New Viking is playing also tonight at Johnny Brenda's in Philly. So that, looking forward to that a lot. Really should be a good time. I'm kind of at a loss here. I guess this is the when you have a talk show, a daily talk show as it is, you get yourself into positions when you're just kind of filling dead air with the sounds of a human speaking voice. And I guess if you want to look at it, just totally strip away everything else and examine what exactly I'm doing here with this program, I think you can make the point, or make a case, that it's exists for no other reason than, well, I mean, I've talked about this before, about how the idea when you're trapped in your car and as an artist and you're getting from point A to point B and you have no facility to making art, this is an outlet to make something art-like, or I envision this show and being on the air, so to speak, being on YouTube.com and being linked to on my website, VernonHowl.com, I've been alive for 11,000, over 11,000 days so far in my life. And I would like to think that my life is not even half over. So you have to think that, barring weekends and vacations and the fact that it's not quite daily and, you're going to have the rerun periods that I'm hoping that this show could last for, I don't see why it couldn't last for a good 10,000 episode run. I think we got that in us, and I'm blessed with a great iPhone 4 and blessed with a good car. Knock on wood. We might even try and do special editions of the show down the line that aren't even involved, with cars aren't even involved. So get some good interviews. I think Oprah, I don't know how many shows Oprah produced, but I want to at least triple that. So I'm guessing 10,000 would should do that, I think. Which would make it, I believe, the longest running talk show in history. So if we get to 1,000 episodes, or 10,000 episodes, I think that covers it. And that should give us a pretty strong, get some good footing in as far as staying on top of that Guinness record, of which I, as an artist, working in the 21st century, one of my ethos and part of my manifesto, so to speak, is quantity over quality. being alive today is overwhelming, especially for an artist, as it starts to rain here in New Jersey. It's overwhelming in that there's so much existing already, and so it's there's really no point to making it. Really, it comes down to it. It's not a whole hell of a lot of makes sense to try and create new music or art or literature or poems or anything of the ilk of what all of which I dabble in. So my art is to take it and say, well, I'm going to just make more of it for the sake of making more of it to outdo my peers on a pure volume scale, on a scale of pure volume. So it's difficult being someone who also has a full-time job on top of all this to also be the most prolific artist of all time. And then that up for debate, I guess you get that moniker. When I call myself the most prolific artist of all time, I'm obviously spotting myself some X amount of years into the future and hoping that my level of productivity at least stays the same. But even then, I still feel like, you know, maybe I'm not doing enough, even given the limitations that I've already talked about. So as an artist, maybe going down a few different paths that I've talked about on this show, getting back into school, becoming, you know, that would even open it up more to have even more time to create more art and do more things. But anyway, the show here, we're only our ninth episode, which feels like I've been doing this show for, geez, a long time. But it's only been nine episodes, which is kind of hard to believe, to be totally honest with you. But that is what it is. Pulling into a liquor store now. Highly debatable whether I get anything to drink here. I think that's unsafe, really. So I'm gonna go in the liquor store. Parking right now. Okay, so I'm gonna I'm gonna cut this. I'll probably cut this edition short here. And so we'll pick it up later today with the second installment, the B episode of this day, June 6th, 2012, clean day, Philly clean day, as I call it. All right.